This is a summary paper that's really great. I'll share this one on YouTube. If you guys are listening, you can. I will probably post a video of this on my Instagram as a snippet. But if you want to see the whole thing, go on YouTube and watch this visually. The title of the article is "Various Possible Toxicants Involved in Thyroid Dysfunction: A Review." It's great. It goes through all these. It's well referenced. We talked about many of these already. Excess dietary iodine, multiple reference here. Naturally occurring goitrogens. We talked about this. They are found in legumes, plants, amiodarone, lithium, right? In addition to cabbage, cauliflower, broccoli,
soy, turnip, horrible.
Soy enriching foods, big problem. The role of dietary fat talks about when they feed oxidized fats to rats, the thyroid doesn't function. Imagine that. If you eat canola oil, your thyroid might not be happy. The role of green tea, okay? Soy and soybean products, cyanogenic plant foods, cauliflower, cabbage, mustard, turnip, radish, bamboo shoot, cassava, okay? They have been shown to possess anti-TPO activity, right? Moreover, boiled extracts of these cyanogenic plant foods showed highest anti-TPO potential, followed by cooked and raw extract. Goitrin is an active goitrogen present in the plants rutabaga, turnip, and brassica seeds, all right? What does Rhonda Patrick want you to eat? Spinach or broccoli sprout seeds, okay? This is the highest concentration. Role of groundnut, not a lot of people eat groundnut. Role of millet, selenium.
Wait, hold on, doesn't it say though? It says though up there, if you look at that, it does say cooking destroys the enzyme responsible for, so you just covered that, but so they got it wrong there too?
Yep, they got it wrong. They're not accounting for myrosinase produced in the gut.
In the gut, okay.
Yep. The role of millet, selenium deficiency, and vitamin B12 deficiency implicated in autoimmune thyroiditis. Bisphenol A, triclosan. These are xenoestrogens. I did a whole podcast with Anthony J, you guys, if you want to do that. Perchlorates found in rocket fuels. Study conducted on pregnant women living in an industrial area in Southern California. Strong association between urinary perchlorate and decreased total and free thyroxine levels and TSH. Cosmetics. UV filters. This is sunscreen, you guys. This is sunscreen. A sunny on benzophenone 2, which is a sunscreen chemical, another chemical, OMC. I won't read that name. Maybe I will read that name. Octyl methoxy cinnamonate.
Nice.
Causes dose-dependent decreases in serum T3 and T4 concentration. What are you using for sunscreen? Parabens, UV filters in your sunscreen or your cosmetics could affect this. Heavy metals, we talked about this, cadmium and lead, all right? This is a great paper. Smoking, thyroid abnormalities, role of age. So this paper really highlights all of the things that we were just talking about. People can find that paper. Again, it's in the video. It'll be in the Instagram snippet. But that, if you avoid those things, and I think we've touched on all of those, you will probably put your thyroid in a much better position.